I can't just firstly congratulations getting so many praises from you know your fans and everyone. Ever thought about getting so much of praise for the film?
I've dreamed about it my whole life. So like it's just been a long time coming. I was just like, yes, I'm going to do my first film. I'm going to get this kind of response. So it's a dream come true.
But you know, now that you're getting a praise, do you have any guilty about, you know, getting a debut done in a corner, you know, OTT platform?
Nothing like that. Yeah, look at reason for the praise is because I managed to do this role
right.
with everything that it made Tanu who she was, and I guess that's because it worked on an OTT platform.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, no, zero regrets. Yeah.
And talking about, you know, playing Tanu, so bold character it is.
Hmm.
You know, have you ever thought about, you know, ki that somewhere or the other people will judge, karna chahiye, nahi karna chahiye. What was your thought playing?
It's nuts. How everyone in questions is saying, did you think, oh, people would judge, you know, the character, bold character? Ulta, everybody, every girl has messaged or, you know, reached out to me saying, sorry for judging Tanu. Sorry, we want to be more like Tanu. Like, that's what girls are saying. So it's nobody has looked and saying, oh my God, so bold. Everyone either has said we are sorry or has said we want to be as confident as Tanu. And Tanu's given us, you know, more self-esteem. Tanu gave me more confidence. I could not dress the way she does, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, yeah.
What are the changes you have got inside you, you know, after playing Tanu?
Like I said, definitely the kind of body confidence that Tanu has, the kind of, you know, how she doesn't need validation from anybody. You know, she's her own person. People consider her the gold digger, but she knows she's the gold. You know, we all as girls have such, you know, we're so conscious of our bodies, and I've been my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
So something like that, you know what, wear what the hell you want to wear. It doesn't matter who's judging and who cares who's judging.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something.
And you know, you are so much loved on social media. What are the compliments which you are getting from social media?
Like I said, yeah, you know, I'm so excited because people are just responding to Tanu and guilty and not ke, oh, you look so pretty, oh, you look so sweet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I wanted to be judged or my work, and yeah, and that's happening. Just stuff like this, yeah, you know, people, just girls who are just saying thank you for making this film, thank you for doing this role, you know, we're looking forward to more work from you. That's so exciting, and it's so, I don't know, it feels so good to read.
Okay, so you know, we all know that how much close you are with Alia, but then when it comes to Kiara, you know, you work with her, how much strong bond do you share with her?
We've become very close, yeah. We became close from the get-go, from our workshops back in Bombay, which was like a month before we started shooting.
Mm-hmm.
And that time, because obviously the workshops were so intense, all four of us really, you know, glued up. But then on set, we were like inseparable. We used to hang in each other's vans and have stews after and, you know, go to the gym together. She's been great through this entire process. It was very easy for, you know, like a seasoned actor to make the newcomer feel a bit out of place, but nothing like that. It's been great.
But then now you're done with the film. Are you like still in contact?
Key and I, oh, 100% all the time. Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Fully.
Okay, so, you know, being a public figure, you know, there's always one thing you have to think before saying, because, you know, trolling and all is something which is very common these days. And now that you are a public figure and you working on such kind of film where, you know, it talks about feminism, it talks about, you know, Me Too movement, have you ever, you know, made your mind set ki mujhe kuch na kuch bolne se pehle sochna padega so that, you know, you don't get trolled or something like
firstly,
that?
Firstly, my PR wants to kill me because I always say what the hell is on my mind. So that's a big problem. I don't think twice. I don't believe in thinking twice. I feel the reason people are relatable is because they say who they are. They're not afraid to be who they are. That's me, and I've been like that since I'm a kid. Like, everyone's like, tum bahut mufat ho, chup karo sometimes. Know when to say what.
Mm-hmm.
I'm opinionated. I have opinions on a lot of things and I like to talk about them. And you're saying about the film, feminism and all, of course these are conversations that need to be had. Even if they're uncomfortable, they need to be spoken about. Conversations need to spark up. So I'm not afraid, and others should need not be afraid either.
And you know, Me Too movement, when it started, it was so much on, you know, fire, where people were coming out, people were talking. But then after that, now the time came and, you know, the topic disappeared. But then now this film came, do you think that people will now again start talking about it?
It's unfortunate that we need films like this to come out for people to, you know, restart conversation, but that was our aim, yes.
Mm-hmm.
People have a very short attention span.
Mm-hmm.
Anything that blows up blows over also in like no time.
Mm-hmm.
But this is terrible. It's been happening forever, and Me Too is here and it's here to stay, yeah, and it
mm-hmm.
should.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so besides that, you know, in 2019 we have seen you in a single, you know, where you just debuted,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah.
Now that you have done a web series now.
Film!
Sorry, film on web platform. So now, next year, are we supposed to see you on a film?
This year. In 2020, yes, you will.
Are you in talks with something?
Maybe.
Which means you don't want to disclose it. Okay, so after, besides that, you know, Corona is like, the effect can be seen everywhere. Gyms have been closed. How much are you missing your gym?
I'm working out at home. Hello, I'm not stopping to work out, yeah. Luckily, I have a gym in the building, but I'm so OCD, I'm not even going there. But yeah, I'm working out at home. I have to be safe. Everybody else also, please be safe. Work out at home.
Working out at home is like, what are the things which
you're... I have an app, and I also, my trainer, Sarab, I just started a 40-day challenge with him, which he sends workouts every day, the previous day for the next day, which you can do at home. So I'm doing high-intensity workouts every day at home.
Mm-hmm. And how much loss do you think that, you know, Corona has been for the Bollywood industry?
I mean, for every industry, yeah, the whole world is on a standstill. Today I had to go out for a bit and I came back. Mm. It was like a ghost town. I've not seen Bombay like this. It's a bit scary because in my whole life I've not seen something like this ever happen. So it's a loss for everybody and I hope it just blows over soon. Mm. Yeah.
And what was the best compliment did you receive till now?
Girls who are coming out and saying their stories because they are empowered by Tanu. People who are telling me that who are from Jharkhand, Bihar, who saying I got the, you know, the body language and dialect so well. I think those are my two biggest.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so hoping to see you soon.
Thank you.
And all the very best. Thank you so much.